will discuss two cases which are usually very common. Though it has been claimed that leprosy has been eradicated or eliminated, but in a year we get at least 4 new cases, though both multibacillary, possibacillary. And treating leprosy, it seems very easy, as it is an infectious disease, and as the textbook teaches us that there is fixed dose therapy for fixed duration. Nowadays it has become very simple so that everybody can treat it. But when we treat it, the people who treat leprosy, they know that problem arise from unknown corners, and when this arise, then they cause trouble for the patient as well as for the doctor. We know that just remembering that leprosy is an infectious disease which is primarily a disease of the nerve. It is a chronic disease. The incubation period is long, and the port of entry and exit is mostly the nasal through the droplets, though nowadays it is seen that the breaching the skin also can act as a port of exit and entry. It is this is the disease whose positive agent was described elaborately for the first time in the world. So Mycobacterium leprae has got an historical importance, and there are many stories surrounding leprosy, and it has a historical importance, but it is very relevant on today's perspective also. This positive agent is Mycobacterium leprosy, which is a gram-positive acid-fast bacilli. These are mostly intracellular, but can stay in extracellular space also. And these are very persistent in nature, and there are still now there are many researches going on keeping in mind their immunological and therapeutic reactions. We know there are two important reactions, type 1 and type 2 reactions, which are not drug reactions but immunological reactions. Type 2 is called eliminosum leprosum, the type 1 is called that reversal reaction, which is type 1 is type 4 hypersensitive reaction, and eliminosum leprosum is type 3, that is immune complex mediated reaction. So keeping that in mind, we'll show two cases where we faced trouble in treating, and how an old weapon in our armamentarium was used in a novel way to combat that situation. Let us discuss it. What we did actually. We had a patient aged 35-36 years, who was presented with a shiny globular nodules on his earlobes, then forehead, and forearms. These were persistent for 2-3 months. These were non-itchy, and these didn't have any tenderness, but these lesions were multiple in number, and on the earlobe, on the forehead, and on the as it is not working properly, I am extremely sorry for that. There were the lesions, if it can be seen from that distance. On the earlobe, actually, this case we presented about 4 years back, that and we diagnosed it as a case of hysteroid leprosy. We know that hysteroid leprosy is a Histoid leprosy is a variant of multifidal leprosy, which is present where there is supposedly less cell-mediated immunity, and there are multiple in the area of involvement. But unlike lepromatous leprosy, there is not diffuse involvement. The CMI, cell-mediated immunity, is compromised, but it is not as less as in a patient with multivascular leprosy. So the globi, they present the nodules, but the picture of lepromatous leprosy, which we see that diffuse involvement, that is not seen. Here also we can see this thing. There are certain globi. On the forehead, there are certain some globi. So we, as that was a case of histoid leprosy, we started treatment with multi-drug therapy. Multi-drug therapy, you know, that with dapsone, rifampicin, and clofazimine, we started to treat. Dapsone 100 mg daily, clofazimine 300 mg once monthly supervised, and 50 mg daily. With that, rifampicin 600 mg once monthly in empty stomach. So after 4 months of multi-drug therapy, we initially, there were bacillary index of 4 plus and morphological index of 1 plus. But after 4 months of multi-drug therapy, the bacillary index becomes 6 plus and morphological index becomes 7 plus. These are the indicators of infection, and these, by these we can assess the response to treatment. The bacterial bacillary index we see from different areas of skin. We take the skin smear, and the number of bacilli present in number of slides we aggregate. We get 4 to 7 areas, and the total number of pluses we divide by the total number of areas seen. By that we get the bacillary index, and morphological index is the amount of percentage of viable bacilli seen amongst the total number of bacilli. The viable bacilli are non-segmented. The sides are parallel, the ends are rounded, and the length is 5 times that of a brain. And it is a contour staining. When stained with Jaden stain, it is a non-segmented staining. So we have noticed that bacillary index and morphological index both have become worse. So we suspected drug resistance. These were done in School of Tropical Medicine, Kolkata, because these require specialized center. In the leprosy center, they used to do it. Patient was regularly sent to them for follow-up, and they used to do it. As this was a case where we suspected certain problems, because histoid leprosy is not very common, and the treatment also is different from usual treatment. So we used to send the patient for regular follow-up at Kolkata School of Tropical Medicine. So they suspected drug resistance. So they had given, 1 month they had given rifampicin, ofloxacin, and minocycline. Rifampicin 600 daily, ofloxacin 400 daily, and minocycline 100 daily. This is an accepted treatment where drug resistance to usual multi-drug therapy is apprehended. It was given for 4 weeks. It is seen that it kills the persistent bacteria, bacilli, and then multi-drug therapy is useful, which acts against the normal, not so resistant bacilli. So after multi-drug therapy given after 1 year, again that slit skin smear was repeated, and even then it was seen that bacillary index is 4 plus, and again morphological index is 1%. So it was much less than this one, but after 1 year of MDT followed by 1 month of ROM, we expected that it should come to zero. So they suspected that patient may be immunosuppressed. So without going for that T-cell counts, etc., or other sophisticated tests, they did a Mantoux test there. Mantoux test was seen to be negative. So at that point of time, nowadays immunotherapy has come in a novel way in treating the leprosy patients, where usual multi-drug therapy or the newer generation drugs do not act, because it is seen that in immunocompromised patients, BCG boosts their cell-mediated immunity, and if the cell-mediated immunity is better, then the multi-drug therapy can act in a better way. So they had given BCG in that schedule. They have started multidose therapy. With the initiation of multidose therapy, dose one of BCG was given. Is given intradermally at the insertion of delta 0.1 milligram, that is 0.1 ml. Then after 1 year, dose two was given. After 3 months of that, dose three was given. And after each 6 weeks, after each dose of BCG, 1-2 test was repeated. Every time that 1-2 was negative, after and the Becerril index and morphological index came to zero, but the Becerril index gradually become less. After the final dose of fourth dose, that 1-2 become positive, and as well as that 6 weeks we are showing Becerril index is zero and morphological index is zero. Then after fourth dose of BCG, 1-2 become positive, and there was a nodule at the injection site of BCG. That BCG, we know in normal vaccination also, a BCG is told to be effective if there is a papular nodule at the site of injection between 2 and 6 weeks, and in certain cases the nodule also ulcerates. That is a sign of usefulness or effectiveness of that BCG vaccine. In that case, after fourth dose, that when the 1-2 become positive, then there was a nodule, papular nodule at the site of BCG injection. So he was declared cured, and yearly split skin smear is done at School of Tropical Medicine, and for 2 years he remains free of symptoms, and the smear is also negative. So this was a case where there was more.